police in New York are looking for a man who they say shot another man to death as he was getting into his car. The NYPD released this video of the incident that happened in Queens. The man dressed in black seems to be working on his car, but when another man across the street starts getting into his own vehicle, the man in black quickly approaches him from behind and shoots him several times. Then he runs back across the street to close up his car, gets in, and drives away. The victim has been identified as a 46-year-old man from Georgia. The suspect is described as a dark-skinned male, last seen wearing a black hat, a face mask, and black clothing, driving a black and white Nissan sedan. Anyone with information is asked to report their tips to NYPD Crime Stoppers by phone, website, or Twitter. A reward of up to $3,500 is being offered in this case. For Inside Edition Digital, I'm Mara Montalbano.
I saw that marked homicide team. My heart sank.
We start tonight with a Fox 35 exclusive, a grieving mother talking only to Fox 35 News after learning her 20-year-old daughter and 1-year-old granddaughter were both found dead in a car in Orange County. Police are now searching for this man who is still on the run tonight.
Fox 35's Danielle Lama joins us live right now with the story you'll see only on Fox 35 News. So Danielle, the mother just heartbroken.
Absolutely. And tonight she is anxiously waiting on news of an arrest. She says her daughter and her daughter's boyfriend were trying to help the man who's now wanted in this case.
They lose a child and a grandchild. Come on. She's a baby. She's a baby.
A young woman and her child found dead inside a car. Orange County deputies searching for this man tonight, DeJean Griffiths.
Griffiths is a person of interest in that crime, and you know we've already seen his propensity for violence.
The investigation began Tuesday morning when deputies found a man shot outside this apartment complex on Lake Heritage Circle. After he was rushed to the hospital, family members contacted police saying they had not heard from his girlfriend, Masanya Malcolm, and their 1-year-old, Jordania. Latoya Reed is Malcolm's mother.
I called and no answer to both phones.
After regaining consciousness, deputies say Malcolm's boyfriend told them he was shot by a friend who may have also shot Malcolm and driven away with her and their baby in the car. The mother and child were found dead Thursday in a parking lot. Investigators say Malcolm had been shot and Jordania may have died from sitting in the hot car.
This is the worst thing ever, and I hope he's caught.
Reed tells us that the couple had been trying to help Griffiths and that he moved in with them in August. She has a message for him.
May God have mercy upon your soul. DeJean Griffiths, may God have mercy on your soul.
The sheriff's office says Griffiths is wanted for attempted murder, and he's a person of interest in the two deaths. Reed tells me what she believes happened right before that shooting. I'll have more on that at 11. Reporting live tonight outside the Orange County Sheriff's Office, I'm Danielle Lama, Fox 35 News.
Just released of an armed ambush on a pair of sheriff's deputies from Brevard County, Florida. A warning, it is video that could be disturbing to many viewers. Bullets fly when a pair of Florida deputies are suddenly ambushed. It all started with a traffic stop. Deputy Tyler Toman talking to a woman while another person rests against the trunk of the sedan. A second deputy, Brian Potters, approaches the vehicle and inside sees a third adult and a baby, and also a dog in the back seat. He makes small talk about his own kids and asks the adult to get out of the vehicle.
He wants to talk to you. Hey. Is that all you're... Yeah. I'll watch him for you.
He's all right. I got babies.
Oh, you got a dog too? Hell. I'll make sure they're all right. I got babies too, man.
That's when the car door opens and all hell breaks loose. More than 61 bullets fired in less than a minute. The man with the assault rifle hit in the leg, and Deputy Brian Potter shouts out he's been hit. Deputy Potter's disoriented, not realizing the gunman is right behind him. The gunman hammers Potter's in the face with the butt of his rifle, and when Potter's goes down, the gunman keeps beating his face, fracturing his sinus and orbital bones. Deputy Tyler Toman drops his spent clip, quickly reloads his gun before unloading it at the man attacking Deputy Potter's.
Let there be no doubt, this individual got exactly what he deserved. And to those out there who might be foolish enough to ask why we shot him so many times, that answer is simple. Because evil can never be dead enough.
The Brevard County Sheriff says the man who attacked
tonight on Houston's north side, an alleged peeping Tom, is shot and killed outside of a home on Irvington Boulevard. The woman told police she saw the man looking through her window, so she grabbed a rifle, shot through the wall, hitting that man several times. The woman is cooperating with investigators. So far, no charges have been filed.
As people in New Jersey continue to clean up from the flooding last Wednesday from Ida, there's a warning out about those who are trying to take advantage of this vulnerable situation. CBS 2's Meg Baker has the story.
Law enforcement officers are at the only entrance to the Lost Valley section of Manville, monitoring who is coming and who is going. Police are warning of looters primarily looking for scrap metal amongst the rubble.
Scrappers, you know, looking, picking up. And, you know, I know people are, you know, it's their lives out on the curb and they don't want to see people going through it. And these people, they don't understand. They just want to make a dollar. And it's sad that they have to do that, you know, take advantage of people while they're down like this.
John Bentz, Manville's director of the Office of Emergency Management, says extra patrols are in the area. There have also been instances of people pretending to be contractors, asking for money up front for work and never returning.
Don't do it. You know, unless they're unless they're a reputable organization like a Surf Pro or a CPR Restoration, some companies that I know of that have been in town over time. Unless they're a national organization, don't give anybody anything.
He says, beware.
Free TV.
Thanks so much for joining us at 9. I'm Trayson Bragg. We begin with breaking news of a deadly stabbing at a park in Oakland City. CBS 46's Yasmina Alston joins me live from police headquarters. Yasmina, you were able to speak to investigators. What are they telling you?
Yeah, well, Trayson, it was supposed to be a really nice afternoon, but investigators say one man was stabbed during a homecoming celebration at Oakland City Park in the middle of the day. Atlanta police are saying that dozens of people, including family, of course, were at the park when an altercation of some sort happened. During that time is when the man was stabbed, and police say he later died at the hospital. Now, investigators are also telling us that another person was stabbed as well, but that person is expected to be okay. It was, of course, a very scary situation for many people who were there at the park today to enjoy the afternoon.
Yes, absolutely. There were some other people who were here in the park just trying to enjoy the nice weather, so they were affected by it, but everybody seems to be recovering very well.
In Atlanta, City South Side, where a 12-year-old boy was shot and killed.
WGN's Jenna Barnes is live at Chicago Police Area 2 headquarters with what she's learning. Jenna.
Yeah, it's Aman and Jackie. The detectives here at Area 2 were the ones responsible for investigating the killing of that 12-year-old. Police say he was shot in the head in what's considered a domestic incident. This investigation is happening in the 8,000 block of South Bennett on the south side. Police have released few details about the circumstances of this shooting, but officers tell us a witness found the boy unresponsive this morning around 10:30, and he was pronounced dead there at the scene from a single gunshot wound to the head. Police have taken a 36-year-old woman into custody. We're told this is an incident of domestic violence, but police have not yet said how or if the woman and boy are related. They also have not yet released the name of the boy who was killed, but as soon as we learn any updates from police, we will let you know. For now, we're live in Pullman. Jenna Barnes, WGN News.
Well, Shad, one of them died. CBS 2's Stephen Graves live at Chicago Police Headquarters. And Stephen, this happened in broad daylight.
Jim, that's right. And just like we see with so many of these mass shootings, we have learned that a vehicle just pulled up, someone inside started firing at a group of people. At least 26 gunshots. That's what witnesses heard around 5 this evening. The many evidence markers. workers on the street near 79th and Ellis back that claim up. Chicago police say the bullets came from someone who pulled up in a dark-colored SUV. The shots hit four people in this vacant lot, all men between the ages of 24 to 27. People who saw the aftermath did not go on camera. One man says the victims hang out in the area a lot and live in nearby apartments. Paramedics took each one of them to local hospitals. The 24-year-old man, police say, died at the University of Chicago. He was shot in the head. Officers say every other victim had gunshot wounds to the legs. Neighbors in this East Chatham community making a point to say they are tired of the shootings. So far this year in the 6th District, which includes the neighborhood, CPD data shows shootings are up 20% compared to last year. One of those victims, shot earlier this summer only blocks from here, was a 9-year-old girl. And another common thread we see in incidents like this, police say no one is in custody for this latest mass shooting. Reporting live at Chicago Police Headquarters, Stephen Graves, CBS 2 News. Jim.
Stephen, thank you.
Tragedy in Brooklyn after a baby is killed in a hit-and-run crash. Several people were hurt, including the child's parents. CBS 2's Christina Phan joins us live from the scene in Clinton Hill. Christina?
Good morning, Cindy. Absolute tragedy for this family of three. Mom, dad, and baby were out for a walk Saturday afternoon when a car slammed into that baby's stroller. You can see it behind us there on the sidewalk, sending the three-month-old girl flying into the air. Police say the Honda with the massive front end damage to the right is responsible for causing the deadly chain of events. Investigators believe the driver was going the wrong way down Gates Avenue and T-boned another Honda going northbound on Vanderbilt Avenue. The impact sent one of the cars barreling into a family standing nearby. A three-month-old baby girl was killed. Her 33-year-old mother was critically injured, and her 36-year-old father also sustained injuries. The driver and passenger of the T-boned car were also rushed to the hospital, and witnesses and neighbors ran over after hearing piercing screams.
We went out the window and we just saw, we heard huge screams of, oh my God. And then there was a woman lying down on the floor.
And police say there were two people in the Honda that caused this crash. Both tried running away from police, but they eventually caught one of them. Officers now believe the 28-year-old man they caught was the driver. Charges against him are now pending, and police are, of course, still searching for his passenger. And just to clarify how this crash happened, Gates Avenue behind us, as you can see, is a two-way street. But on this side of Vanderbilt Avenue, it is a one-way street. And officers say this is the direction the suspect came in. And we just spoke with a few neighbors and families who are familiar with this intersection. They say it is very difficult to make an incorrect turn onto this one-way street, a very difficult mistake to make. Police, of course, now looking into how this all happened. We're live from Clinton Hill, Brooklyn. Christina Phan, CBS.
8 months pregnant and had just been the center of attention at a baby shower in her honor. Neighbors say she was unloading her baby gifts into the lobby of her apartment building on West 128th Street and Frederick Douglass Boulevard when a fight broke out between two men. According to police sources, the fight was between her current boyfriend and the father of several of her previous children. Police say Young was shot in the face and died at Harlem Hospital.
What happened to Shanice is a tragic, and it could have happened to me. I'm a survivor of domestic violence, and 15 years ago when I was leaving my abuser, I almost was killed.
This shooting happened at 1:15 Sunday morning, and Robert Rice, the chaplain for Harlem Hospital, spent the next several hours consoling family members about the violent death of this young pregnant mother.
This right here was a senseless shooting. I'm very upset and I'm angry. I shouldn't be angry as a clergy, but this one here has touched my heart.
First brought to you on Saturday, it is no bail for 37-year-old Fallon Harris. She's charged with first-degree murder in the death of her 12-year-old son. Her family told police she shot Caden Ingram over a missing SD card from her car. After she first shot him, police say Harris demanded the card again. When Ingram said he didn't know where it was, his mother shot him a second time. Ingram then died at the hospital. Family members say Harris is suffering from paranoia. When police arrived at their home, she admitted to shooting her son and led them to her gun. Harris is in court again tomorrow.
Inside a Brooklyn subway station. It happened just after 7 o'clock Thursday night at the Atlantic Avenue Barclay Center station in Borham Hill. Sources say the 32-year-old victim told the suspect he should say, "Excuse me," after he passed her. Well, that's apparently when he turned around and kicked her in the chest. The woman suffered cuts and bruises to her body and hurt her ankle, but refused medical attention at the scene. Police are still searching for the suspect.
This dude right here stole a Bible. And he ain't gonna read it neither.
Hostess at a popular restaurant, and police say they were asked to show proof of vaccination. That's what led to this. Now three people are facing charges.
It happened yesterday evening at Carmine's on the Upper West Side. CBS's Natalie Dedridge joins us live with the details and a closer look at the video. Natalie.
Well, Cindy and Mary, this is exactly what some business owners feared when enforcement of vaccine verification went into place on Monday. Now, this popular restaurant even took these measures to put up signs that say New York City requires you to be vaccinated against COVID-19 to enter this business. But that did not stop what happened next.
Cell phone video shows several women involved in a scuffle that almost knocks over the hostess booth at Carmine's restaurant on Broadway and West 90th around 5 o'clock last night. The NYPD says a 24-year-old hostess was punched, slapped, and pushed when she asked a group of diners to show proof of COVID-19 vaccination, a city policy, to eat indoors. Police say three women from Texas, a 44-year-old and her 21-year-old daughter, and a 49-year-old woman became enraged, even yanking off the victim's necklace during the assault. She was okay and declined medical attention. You can see two men drag one woman away from the fight. The three women from Texas were given desk appearance tickets and taken into custody. The New York City Hospitality Alliance issued a statement on behalf of Carmine saying, "It's a shocking and tragic situation when one of our valued employees is assaulted for doing their job as required by city policies and trying to make a living. This is the absolute last experience any of our employees should ever endure and any customers witness." The Hospitality Alliance is calling on the city and state to increase penalties for assaulting restaurant workers in conjunction with enforcement of COVID-19 protocols. Adding, Mayor de Blasio must do a better job making visitors to New York City aware of the vaccine card policy. Restaurant owners who do not comply with the mandate can face fines starting at $1,000.
Suspects wanted in a robbery and shooting outside of an upscale Manhattan restaurant.
Police say that the suspected targets, the suspects targeted outdoor diners. And tonight we are hearing from the mother of the man who was shot after a struggle. CBS News' Nick Calloway live on the Upper East Side for us with more. Nick.
Well, it was a scary situation here last night. A man was shot while he was in the outdoor dining area outside of a restaurant. And police say it all started as a robbery over expensive jewelry.
Guys ran up on him with the guns, and he tried to defend himself and fought them off and got shot in the process.
Lisa Cook is relieved her son, Melshire, is still alive after he was shot Wednesday night. Video shows NYPD officers running down a blood-spattered sidewalk toward the restaurant Philippe on East 60th Street near Madison Avenue just after 10 p.m. Moments earlier, neighbors say they heard a loud bang.
So we rushed over to the window and we saw that there was a lot of commotion going outside.
Police say the masked and armed suspects approached separate outdoor tables shouting, "This is a stick-up." One suspect allegedly robbed a 31-year-old eating dinner with his wife, taking the man's Rolex watch. The other suspect went up to 28-year-old Melshire
Shire Cook, who tried to grab the gun. A struggle ensued, and Cook was shot in the leg.
Crawled back into the restaurant with the gun, so that's one less gun on the street in New York City, and I'm proud of him.
The men jumped into a black SUV driven by a third suspect and drove off. Two medical professionals happened to be eating here and jumped in to help.
We went and tried to just apply whatever trauma training we have to just keep the patient stable until EMS was there to arrive.
Wrong place, wrong time, but we were happy to help out, of course.
How are you? I'm so glad you guys are home.
Thursday afternoon, the Democratic nominee for mayor, Eric Adams, stopped by Philippe to meet with staff and have a meal, stressing that public safety will be vital to the city's recovery.
For someone to come by and...